assessment, and he keeps visiting the institutes as well as professional bodies to explain the implication of labor laws, etc. Okay. So with this introduction, I would first take you through
what is an industry, and again it deals with the dispute or differences between a worker and a worker, between a worker and a management, or between like an employer and employer and management. And there are certain norms, as basically there are certain territorial jurisdictions which have to be followed. If that dispute is within that territory or within an area, and for that it has to be very, it is very important that the industry such, it is defined as an industry in the IPA.
What is a contract of employment? If an employer employs an employee, then the contract is a contract of employment. Now, this contract is a contract for personal services. And the basic rule is that a contract of personal services cannot be specifically enforced. In the sense that if a party to the contract terminates the contract illegally or wrongfully, even then the court cannot compel specific performance of the contract. But in India, this basic rule is subject to three exceptions. Like, let us say an employment contract. Employer terminates the services of the employee wrongfully. Now, can an employee go to the court and demand reinstatement in service? If the court awards reinstatement, this would amount to specific performance of the contract. Now, a civil court, like I said that in India, this rule is subject to three exceptions. First exception is for employees who are governed by Article 311 of the Constitution of India, civil service, government service. Second exception is if an employee of a statutory company is terminated in violation of a statutory rule, then also the courts can grant reinstatement. Third exception is for employees falling within the ambit of the industrial dispute, who are industrial employees, who are workmen under the industrial dispute. So, like a manager, for instance, who doesn't fall in the industrial dispute act and also doesn't fall in the first two categories, Article 311 or a statutory company. In India, there is no protection in the sense that if an employer terminates the services, then he cannot go to the labor court or industrial tribunal since he is not a workman under the IPA Act. He can only go to a civil court, and a civil court cannot grant specific performance of the contract. So a civil court ordinarily would not be competent to award reinstatement even upon finding that the contract was wrongfully terminated. At the most, the civil court can grant damages for wrongful termination. So, Industrial Disputes Act is a special enactment. Now, the main purpose of this statute was to provide for mechanics of dispute resolution, to provide for investigation and settlement of industrial disputes, to provide for a forum whereby industrial peace is promoted and the energy of the partners is not dissipated in counterproductive battles. So, the main object of the Act is to promote industrial peace and harmony, to prohibit illegal strikes and illegal lockouts, and certain other incidental objects, plus also to provide for investigation and settlement, including adjudication and arbitration of industrial disputes. Now, as you said, that industrial disputes act, skill, supervisory, technical, operational, or clerical. So these seven categories are prescribed. Then certain exceptions are there. For your purposes, two main exceptions are that if any such employee is employed in a managerial or administrative capacity, then he will not be a workman. Or if he is employed in a supervisory capacity and drawing wages exceeding ₹10,000 per month, then also he would not be a workman. And plus, if any employee, by virtue of the office or duties, exercises mainly managerial functions, then also he would not be a workman. So in nutshell, any employee who is employed in a supervisory or managerial or administrative capacity would not be a workman. Of course, the supervisory employee would be taken out only if he is drawing salary of ₹10,000. And incidentally, this in 86-84 onwards, okay, then you see industrial dispute. It is necessary for a dispute to be an industrial dispute. If it's not an industrial dispute, then a labor court or a tribunal would not be competent to adjudicate upon it. The labor, see, for the purposes of investigation and settlement of industrial disputes, the government constitutes a machinery of conciliation officers, the appropriate government. Whatever is the appropriate government, central government or the state government, it has conciliation officers. It could also provide for a board of conciliation or a board of inquiry. The conciliation officer is statutorily charged with mediating in and promoting for the settlement of industrial disputes. If settlement is not possible, then the appropriate government refers the dispute for adjudication to a labor court or industrial tribunal.